I'll be acting as chair in place of Mike Sullivan, who gives his apologies to Mike's in hospital. Councillor and I are going to use a substitute with Matt Daniel. Are there any apologies? No?
For you, Chair, Councillor, if you can have the members to be here this evening, we want to present it.
Right, okay. And there's two other cabinet members with apologies, Councillor George Davis and also this evening. Okay, thanks very much indeed. Okay. Can I invite members to declare any interest for the party to declare any interest? Okay, right, thank you. Okay, we've got any apologies for absence. We go on now to item two. So approve the accuracy of the minutes of the last meeting on the 23rd of March. Is that okay?
Agree.
Okay, thank you. Next item is item three, pages 7 to 16. I'd like to invite Chucky Lande to present a report in relation to tourism and to invite comments and questions from the committee members. Okay? Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. The thing I'd like to reveal that's not in the report because we have now literally a couple of days after this report went on to the internet is that world's visitor economy is now the fastest growing in the city region in Merseyside. From 2013 to 2014, there was actually an increase of 8.4%, which is genuinely the fastest growing now in the city region as a whole. So I'm sure you'll all be doing that as we go on. I don't know whether you want me to go through it item by item.
I've lost
page 10, and throughout the report there's mention about the food offer on Wirral and the pull that food as an offer for tourism is working on Wirral, and I'd just like to expand on that, to give a bit more beef and background.
What the Vista research told us in 2006 and 2011 that Wirral's key assets are coast, countryside. We call it the three C's internally: coast, countryside, and cuisine. So coast, countryside, and food and drink. It's people both are existing visitors and are potential visitors. Over 80%. Come to Wirral for that offer, coast, countryside, quality food and drink, and that's why the focus is still on those particular elements. In 2006, we developed in partnership the Wirral Food and Drink Festival with Andy Kimley, people will know from Claremont Farm. We actually secured some European funds for the first couple of years to fund that event. Now it's completely self-financing. I think it's in its 10th year. Changed its name to Farm Feast, Wirral Farm Feast. We do a regular food and drink guide, which is done every 2 years. It's pretty much self-financing through advertising. So a small circulation and it's an online downloadable version. So that's where the food and drink element comes into Wirral's tourism offer.
Thank you, Chair. Just a couple of points, really. Firstly, it all seems very positive. It's really good news for Wirral. It's always good, I find, if you're quoting figures. It's nice to see a graph of our sort of improvement. And also, if we're looking at improvements and saying how good we are, maybe a comparison of national averages. So it may be that the national picture is improving, you know, across the UK, where part of the trend, we might be walking the trend. It's nice to be able to. I think there are a couple of figures, but it's just to see the growth, you know, since over the years, if you're able to see that, if you've got the detail. And the other question really is, on the term of investment on specific items, do you have sort of figures, so when you've done more particular items, say the food and drink guide, do you know what that sort of brings in, or is it kind of that we do lots of things and overall it's improved, or do you have individual data on what's working, what isn't, so we can improve things?
Some things are easily evaluated. We do press visits, and there is a press value, there's an economic impact. Events are equatable, obviously, but campaigns are always very difficult, and our campaigns are actually competition-led, so it's about hits on websites, competition entries, so we see all of our activity having a value to, if you like, contributing to the economic impact for Wirral's visitor economy.
Okay. So you've got like website hits, if you've done something specific. So
we track that all on a monthly, if not merit basis.
Great. Thank you. Thank you.
Councillor Beasley.
Yeah, I just welcome this report. It's absolutely great news that we're hearing. Suppose not a criticism, but just a question really about why we're not promoting some of the heritage and our parks and gardens, especially with the links with Central Park and America, and beautiful sunlight and the likes of that. Is there a reason why we're not sort of promoting those at the front?
If I take Birkbeck Park, I'm actually on the panel that's now developing the World Heritage Site status for Birkenhead Park.
I'm a local councillor, so
you know what,
you're not promoting it out there,
very well. It's actually led by Professor Robert Lee, and Adam King, and Mary Worrell. And in terms of Port Sunlight, and the Asian Port Sunlight, all the time, it's a huge visitor attraction. They're looking, and obviously it's all about funding, but they're looking to...
Sorry, could you use your microphone so we can hear you back here? Sorry, it's a long way away. Thanks.
Sorry. They're looking to develop motorway signage through Highways England, which obviously will attract even more visitors to Port Sunlight, and they're looking at a number of projects within Port Sunlight itself. So although it's not specifically highlighted in there, there are obviously a lot more than, you know, I've highlighted key highlights in the report. Stuff like that is going on all the time.
Sorry, I think just very briefly for you, Chair, as well, just another positive point is that we have certainly recognised the importance of marketing and the visitor aspect with our parks. Members will be aware that we've been through a remodelling exercise recently to save money and review our structure. But even as part of that, we have taken the opportunity to create a brand new marketing and visitor supervisor post, which will sit in the parks team, dedicated to working in this area, in certainly in Burton Head and on the park. Yes.
Sorry, Chair, it's just that my
Port Sunlight, as I said, is I'm working with Port Sunlight, if you like, on a one-to-one basis, even though it might not be in this report, in terms of trying to attract even more visitors through motorway signage and internal interpretation, and in terms of heritage overall, we obviously do promote heritage as part of, we have a World Tourism Business Network, private sector led. Within that partnership, sort of that network, there is the History and Heritage Partnership, there is an Attractions Partnership, and there's key heritage assets within the Attractions Partnership. So, Birkenhead Priory is in there, Williamson Art Gallery is in there, so key heritage assets are being promoted.
Do you think we're actually maximising
highlighted some detail in the report about, and the cruise line coming to Liverpool is fantastic, but any excursions are very much led by the passengers themselves. Obviously we promote packages to them, but it's the take-up of the passengers themselves. It's need led, you know, they're paying for it after all.
So Chair, can I just add to that? I think the answer is yes, we do, as Julie said. We are aware of a number of ships that come in which have visitors to Port Sunlight. And only last week I was down at Burger Club, and there were actually 80 people off the cruise ship that they must be playing off over at Burger Club. So I think it's fair to say that we have attractions which are both world class. You know, these people are cruising around the world, when they want to go on the leadership, so we have those lots of people on.
I can just ask a few questions just because clearly people can come in. I mean, from my own point of view, I mean, I think we need to work smarter with our partners and neighbours. One of the great criticisms as Heritage Champion and seeking heritage groups is that basically a lot of the in relation to the lack, for instance, understand what he's saying, they're there to promote Liverpool. The big question everyone is asking is, we're all getting a share of the pie on this issue, and many people think that we are not. We can't rely on the badge holders to promote Liverpool, because they're running businesses that only, I think, 90% of them are from the Liverpool area anyway. So there's a whole number of things I think we do need to do. I think there needs to be a sea change. I don't think heritage has been well promoted. And as I said, I'm going not only for my own opinions, but also the opinions from heritage groups and a whole host of other people around the world. So I think there's a lot more we need to do. I appreciate the limitations that you have in the department. I know, no disrespect to that, Jimmy. But I think what we should be doing as a council is putting more and more pressure on the left to get a piece of the pie. And there has been criticisms in the past that the left have been very, very pro-Liverpool. Well, you'd expect them to be pro-Liverpool, but as I said, we have got to argue for our share of the pie, and I think that's really important. I think we need to work smarter with our farmers and neighbours to maximise the tourism potential. And so that's basically, you know, my comments for what it's worth.
I think, Bill Chair, I think the only thing I'd say is that I know Julie does work very closely with you know, obviously marketing Liverpool, which is outside, but I'm just responsible for all the marketing activities for Liverpool City Council, and obviously does put a significant amount of resource into this area, and I'm not questioning for one moment, far from it, our heritage assets, but unfortunately, many people on the groups in particular would prefer to visit the likes of the cathedrals and Ebony Beatles over the Liverpool, and remember they're only here for a short period of time. I think
that's agreed with that.
Well, unfortunately, yeah, that's true. Unfortunately, we've got to be doing that in the future. I think the second thing that I'd just say on that about the blue badge guides, I know full well that Juggy and his team have a number throughout the year of familiarisation visits with those blue badge guides to bring them over to the road and see the assets. And yes, I'm sure a large number do live in the world, but certainly that's a large number in the world as well. And you like the volunteers and some of us are interested in actually writing in terms of their own assets and their own particular interests. We will obviously continue to work with all external partners, particularly given the pledge that the leader made in his 2020 vision to increase this, I think, already a successful economy by a further £100 million over the next 5 years, which is a 5% year-on-year growth. So, you know, it's a challenging target, to be honest with you, in an area which I look at what Jugger's team achieved with, I mean, say four, in reality it's only three, but with four people in the team, this is something that's absolutely led, I think, a good example for the council, and it's absolutely led by the private sector. With the private sector, or demonstrate their assets and use. So Chair, I understand our assets are fantastic, but someone's come into Liverpool for a 4 or 5 hour visit, I'm afraid we are competing with what in any world a world-class tourist attractions in Ebony Beacles and the universities. That's what I mean.
Just one minute. First of all, the blue badge guides are just a time and a part of the renewal of Mosey heritage. Just a time, and so that's one issue. But the other point is, I mean, our industrial now is working on real champions, you know, volunteers to come forward and promote the will. Also, the government promoting the course for the colleges for health and safety and, you know, safeguarding and everything else. That is one of the ways that we're moving forward by promoting ourselves. Well, God helps those who help themselves, and I think, you know, that is a real key issue there. Just go on to Rob Gaston next, and I've got to do an answer as well.
Thanks, Chair. Julie, excellent report. The figures that are coming, 155 million, they're not the fastest growing visitor economy on the Mersey side, is what you mean there. So, you know, that's all great. Now, I was just going through this, I've lost my place, so I won't bore you with the details, but it says the visitors that we attract tend to be 55 plus. I'll be missing a trick somewhere there in our market and how we appeal to a younger base as well. I mean, I agree with what Kevin was saying there, that our heritage is fine, it's nothing to be ashamed of. But a trip around the museum and our gallery and walking down the guide is not what you've just come 3,000 miles for. You know, we come to Liverpool for purpose. But there are other tourists that need to be attracted. Local tourists, people from the Mersey side area that have seen all that, lived in, you know, we can get them over here. So what's our marketing doing to try and sex up them? Sex up them. There's a song for
is attracting families into rural. That wasn't there 5 years ago. So it's about about changing our marketing, it's evolving as we move forward, but predominantly still we're looking at it because it's coast and countryside and quality food. But until we do that, and we do it that every 5 years, that rate increases, that will then inform where we're going and what we then do. So yeah, it's completely flexible, but there is a finite budget we've got to spend.
Okay, and finally, final point, sorry. Obviously, being from the Hill, there's no point in promoting us to ourselves. But if I was in tourist lands in Stafford or somewhere like that, are we marketing that part of the field then? So in what ways? You know, you go to a hotel anywhere in Wales, in North Wales, you'll see little flyers there saying go to this area, that area. You know, the whole of Wales is marketed right across the board. Are we on tourist boards in other places around the country?
Yeah, all of our sort of guides are distributed throughout the tourist information centre networks around the country. We do two specific campaigns. One is a short break campaign, so that's to support the accommodation as well as our assets, and a day visitor campaign, which is called, so the national campaign for short breakers is called Discover We're All. The day visitor campaign is the Wonders of We're All, which is really to support the attractions in We're All. So that's what the split is, and the split is really 2/3 of the visitor economy comes in for day visits and 1/3 for short breaks, and that's how we split the budget in terms of that target audience. But predominantly our target audience is that 90-minute, 2-hour drive time of We're All, other than obviously key assets like golf.
Councillor David Mitchell.
Thank you very much, Chair. A few points. First of all, excellent report to be made. It's clarity in itself, because you're only information that you require to know what's going on. And I have a quick look at the Visit World site. Really is an excellent site, and it does come up well in a very good way. There are one or two things that maybe need promoting more, like it's been said before, bringing people in from outside the area. When, like the colleague here, when we were previous mayors of the authority, we travel around a lot, we saw a lot of things going on. It does give a great impression. And one of the things that struck me, I mentioned it in this committee before, was the sand yachting at Mells. And it's an international event. Well, I only knew it was an international sand yachting event because I was driving past. You know, this is the sort of thing that we, going back to what Greg was saying, the sort of thing we should be promoting a lot more and helping get ourselves on the map, because if other people see what wonderful things are happening on our doorstep and in our boundaries, then it's beneficial for all of us. The one thing that did strike me was the restructuring of the budget team, the budgeting problem and the restructuring of the tourism team. As I've said before, it's an excellent report. You're doing absolutely fantastic work in that. I noticed that the report is written by yourself, but the heading is by the head of neighbourhood and engagement, who's having been off for quite a while. Are you managing okay with not having the head to support you in putting all these assets and things into place?
What I would like to say is that David Armstrong has been overseeing our division and has been fantastic support. As Kevin has, as the strategic director, has been really fantastic with us. In terms of feedback about the events, I think I've highlighted again in the report, unfortunately, the events budget was put forward as a budget saving, so we can't directly support events with a budget. And obviously, through EBRs, the events officer also left us, and we can't build poster again because of budget savings. So there are limitations, but we do as much as we can. You know, events are all on our website, we promote it that way, obviously through our literature as well.
But the thing is, it's not actually putting funds in to promote the thing, it's actually helping them to advertise,
sure,
and get out to the general public. And I think that's something that maybe should be looked at through the cabinet members to see that, because the benefits are fantastic.
Absolutely.
The figures that are coming through on this report are absolutely marvellous.
not only in the revenue generated, but the employment that's created, and it's something that we should be looking a lot more to do. The other side of that is, and I received an email today, being an Eastern Ward councillor, filming taking place in our local country park over 4 days. This is something else that brings money into the economy. You saw the scenes, years ago, a comedy series on the TV, which helps promote the bill. And hopefully, yes.
Okay. Hey, David.
Hopefully, we can get more.
Absolutely agree.
Right, okay.
Councillor Bird. Thank you, Chair. Thanks, Joey, for this report. It's quite comprehensive. There's some things I'm quite not 100% with, but I think Dave beat me to the punch. I was just going to ask everyone how many knows that we do have Sandy Ossie. If the European Championships 2 years ago, we also had the British Championships, and I'm the local councillor, and I didn't know until about 3 or 4 days after it happened. So I'm with the leader on this, where we're going to promote what we've got. And if we're trying to get people in, these are the type of people we've got. European Champions, I believe, is going to Morgan now. We've lost that. And if you also look at the top, we've got the European Center, so we've got the opening. But over the last 3 or 4 years, we've had the British Boys Championship, we've had the Ladies Championship. Last week, or the week before, we had the Cheshire Boys Championship. Nothing's ever said, and I live within 100 yards of the club. And I don't know unless I'm actually looking to see what's going on. So promotional, as Lisa was saying, is one of the most we've got to sell will. The only way to sell it is to promote it, get it out there, and the fly letters and so on and so forth. Get it stuck up. Let's promote ourselves. It's a beautiful area. There's no doubt about that. But promotion and advertising. Let's get down to it. Thank you.
Thanks for that, Eddie.
Right, sir.
Just go to Jean Stevenson first.
Well, I'm just going to be the same drum as being before. It's heritage and tourism, not passions and heritage. And then I know we've got restricted resources. But, Julie, you said that the world offer is determined by the research you're doing in businesses. But if we don't know what's on offer,
I'm just wondering, The, about the casino in New Brighton, I don't want to be bringing this down. Obviously, it's quite upsetting today that that is actually closing. I'm just wondering, do you know what sort of impact it's going to have? Or is there something going to be there ready to go into the building? And just to make a little comment on that, why aren't we going and giving our visitors guides onto these ships so that they're giving them out to the people on the ships? So, but I'm more interested, obviously, than New Brighton.
In terms of the cruise lines, we actually do. There is a cruise, I think I've written the report, there is a cruise line operations manager who we liaise with, Angie Redhead. So there's packages we put together in partnership with our tourism business network that then go forward to passengers who are then, the operations managers of each cruise liner, who then liaise with the passengers. So they're sold as packages, but obviously we put in loads of packages and it's got to be led by the passengers who actually want to buy the packages. And Port Sunlight is very, very popular, and Royal Liverpool, as Karen said, is very, very popular. And they actually both have won out across the whole of Merseyside, I believe, in terms of customer feedback. They get something like 98 or 100% feedback. So they are coming, and the feedback is fantastic, but they are limited. In terms of the casino,
I mean, to you, Chair, I mean, obviously, the casino, this Darren Spence still in consultation with the staff, so I think it would be too early to say too much. However, should the casino finally close, I'm confident, Chair, that there would be another use for it. Quite funny there, because there's a lot of places where the casino will block people losing money, because people aren't losing enough money.
Chair, just on that point, can I declare a personal
interest?
Chair, it's not about the debate.
Okay.
It's regard to the casino
and
issues that have been discussed. I'm a member of the Licensing Act 2003 committee,
which
deals with the issue of licensing. So I'm just dealing with a personal declaration of interest.
Thank you.
Well, I'm going to get a size point. First, congratulations again that contributed, as always, for the report that's produced. But I don't think this would be a good opportunity to mention that. If this is the scene committee, what about reintroducing the idea of a tool for members of seeing some of the things that you do? And Mark mentioned the park as well. We just talked about these things, and a lot of them don't talk about it. Well, I've never seen the thing we talk about suicide. Like Dave, I had the pleasure of being a man a year or two ago. And it's an amazing open eye-opening exercise that you see things that really you didn't know existed. But if you're not there, you don't see them. And so I recommend you all be there a lot. So, if you pass on to the appropriate people, Jerry, shall we look again at the being a tour of the most interesting thing we've
done? I think that would be a great idea, and we have done this occasionally in the past. If the agreements are going wrong, we ask the officers to look into that and come back to the community.
It's quite a few years since last.
Do I have any agreements of anyone to the officers to go away? Okay, fine, thank you.
Okay, is that all on the stage,
Jerry? Yeah, councillor Christopher's.
Just on that, you've got a suggestion for forward. But I think, you know, in light of all the cuts being made, the public perception of us having a truck store around the river may not go down too well. I think that needs to be the debate rather than booking a chat about it.
Okay, I didn't suggest a coach tour. But if it could be looked, that's no cost, where you could visit certain venues. It's a no cost situation. Please can I emphasise that?
You do it on the bike.
Right, so yeah, Councillor Christopher.
No, look, I'm new on the committee, so nice to join you all. I just want to say a couple of things really. One is that, when we look at the likes of Liverpool, I mean, it's not that long ago that it wasn't the absolute wonderful centre of tourism and visitor economy that it is now. You know, we started, you know, not that long ago, and it's obviously boomed. So it's something that we need to, you know, bear in mind that we can have a vision and we can grow our tourism. It's not a given. It didn't just happen that loads of people are going there. It started quite small. It had really massive image problems not that long ago. And then they didn't have a very, very big team helping on culture and tourism. But because the smart moves were made, it's grown and developed. And I think it's a lesson that we should learn and realise we can aspire to get there, really. I think in terms of your consultation with tourists, I think it might be quite interesting because there's been a lot of comments made about who are these tourists, the profile of tourists, the different target groups, because not all tourists are the same, you know, they're not all the same age, they're not all the same, they're not all looking for the same thing. You talk about 5.1, that consultation is planned in 2016 for both existing and potential visitors to Wirral. I just think it might be quite interesting for this committee to have a look at what you've got planned in terms of what questions you're going to be asking, you know, what's going to be in that consultation, because I think that might be quite useful for us to have a look at and see, you know, what we think about the questions that you're asking. Okay, thanks.
Okay, Councillor Steve Williams.
Thanks, Chair. I agree totally with that. I've got all these people coming in and you say, if some of the Rob Gregson mentioned, maybe he mentioned about, I don't know the word about, but doing it to ourselves, promoting to ourselves.
Sexy middle.
For the people on the middle, it's a good point because I'm lucky in the fact that I've visited a lot of cities around the world, and the first thing we do is get on the open top bus, which costs quite a few more. We go to all these museums and that. And then I suddenly realised that I've never been to the Beatles Museum, Port Sunlight Museum, the Maritime Museum. I didn't go on the Duck Amphibian Fling before it was that happened. I wonder, is it just me that's strange? Or is there a lot of just to answer but is there a lot of people on the world, you know, it's a good point. It's probably a lot the same as me. You know, you go to Oxford, the first thing you do, well, what can I go and visit? You go around here and we don't go to Oxford. So it's just worth considering advertising to our own company, because you could advertise to our own.
I mentioned two campaigns that we do, the Discover Wirral, which is the national, regional national, and the Wonders of Wirral, which is to support our own key attractions. And that is promoted both locally and regionally, locally by the sort of Mersey Rail, Mersey Travel Network. So we do some local promotion as well to take up that point.
Yeah, but sir, I think members have made the point about promoting to ourselves, and I'm sure Julie and colleagues will look at how we can maybe do more, maybe through our internet sites and campaigns to let people in the world know about the opportunity to get on their doorsteps, so they spend more money getting less elsewhere. So we're going to do that as well.
Yeah, I mean, let me just make more comments.
Hey,
Rob, see you next.
Just on that about promotion, there was what Dave was saying before about this Sam John and this thing, you know, this things going on that I'm not aware of. Surely we should be attracting groups like that in as well and going out to them. You know, because we've just had refight the battle of Waterloo over in Belgium there. You know, there's all these groups around or whatever. Maybe we could reach out to these groups. You've got plenty of open spaces and things to say, you could do your reenactments here. Because they're always looking for places. You know, we've got strong backing groups, historical groups. You could bring them in, they've got their own types of followers. So that's us actually providing facilities to bring other services in. And it seems to be age group as well.
Councillor Steve Nicholl.
Thanks, Chair. Much has been mentioned actually, thank you by the way for colleagues and officers about Port Sunlight, which happens to be in our ward. It is interesting to note that Julie mentioned about motorway signage to draw further visitors to our wonderful and absolutely brilliant tourist attraction in our ward. But it would have been nice to pick up on Councillor Bob's point about communication. Well, councillors have been advised of their discussions and all the rest of it and been involved. I mean, there are things like the new Riverview Park, for example, which can be viewed from Port Sunlight, and how that links into the tourist officer offering of the cruise liners coming in, particularly when the Riverview Park is where the ferry tour turns around, and everybody gets the joy of. Taken it many a time with visitors from outside our area and listened to ferry across the Mersey more than once, believe me, as we all have. but again, I mean, it's like classic. Why haven't we got something like a piece of iconic art? It was mentioned many moons ago in the early days of New Brighton about having Poseidon or Neptune. I can't remember, it was all about it so long ago, which never came to fruition, although clearly the attraction for visitors to New Brighton is stunning now. But again, I mean, these are the kind of things that perhaps we need to be looking at with regard to our tourist offer, and therefore bringing even further money in to the area. And given the comments that members have so far made, and I'm sure there'll be even more, I think actually perhaps we need to set up a task and finish group to looking at developing the tourist offer, and members actually taking hold of it and saying, where are we going? Because there's been all sorts of things that have been mentioned that aren't covered in the report that members working with the local community might be able to put into an offer, and therefore further develop our tourism strategy and policy. And I would move that, Chair.
Okay. So we've got a mover and we've got a seconder. That's what we need to reach. Is that a great plan, by the way? If we ask a commission to discuss tourism.
I think something that we should look at. I think we should look at and move on. Subjects, you know, I think should be there as part of, you know, our discussion.
Yeah, we'd like that to be added to the agenda. Okay, just to increase.
Yeah, I was going to make a recommendation, and it's related to all the points that have been raised during the debate, all members, and I was going to move that given the amount of revenue and employment generated through the visitor economy, this committee recommends that the Cabinet reviews and enhances the team that supplies that.
Just quickly on that, I think that's already restructuring has already been being looked at, isn't it, from a point of general point of view of all the departments.
Well, taking the views that the review itself that took place, and the head of the services has not been in this building for over 6 months. Obviously, there's a saving that could be made because the work is still getting done, and if we need to improve the amount of people actually doing the job on the floor, then that's one way of looking at it.
Is that a conversation?
Well, it was, yes.
And you have a second, wasn't it?
No.
Chair.
You have a second, that's okay. Jean.
Might I suggest that that's a bit premature? I think it's probably best if we have a task and finish group there.
Well, I was just going to say, the task and finish group can cover a number of those areas, can't it?
I'll second that, Chair. Can I just ask a question?
Sorry, Jean, I was going to bring you in. Yeah, that's okay.
Just wanted to ask you, you mentioned the wonders of waiting.